Good evening, everyone. I am Timothy Pachulo, principal of South Ocean Middle School, and at this time I would like to invite our select choir members to the stage. Please remain standing for our Pledge of Allegiance, and our select choir members will sing the national anthem. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America,
and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Ms. Dell'Italia, and our select choir members. Please have a seat. On behalf of our assistant principal, Dr. Paula Mace, all of South Ocean's faculty and staff, and our honored guests that are with us tonight, I am very pleased to welcome you to South Ocean Middle School's 2017 eighth grade moving up ceremony. Thank you. I'm so grateful to the Patchogue Theater Board for allowing us to have our ceremony in this amazing theater. There's none other like it. No other building in our district has a ceremony like this one, and it is really an amazing ceremony to experience. At this time, I would like to ask all of our faculty and staff to stand. All of our faculty and staff. I'd like to recognize these individuals for all that they have done for your students over the past 3 years. The daily interactions of compassion, wisdom, and support by these individuals is truly amazing. Our students have been very fortunate to have these positive role models throughout their middle school experience. Thank you for all that you've done for our students. I'd like to welcome our honored guests. We have Ms. Marianne Ambrosini, our Assistant Superintendent for Special Education and Pupil Services. Ms. Kellyanne Jennings, Board of Education First Vice President. And from the Village of Patchogue, Deputy Mayor Jack Krieger. Thank you so much for your support and being with us this evening. It is my sincere pleasure to honor and recognize our eighth grade students this evening. The promotion from middle school to high school is an important milestone in life. Any milestone represents a time in our lives when we should look back to reflect upon the steps that we took to achieve such greatness. They also encourage us to look forward to the promise of good things to come. Thank you to all the parents who have entrusted your children to us over the past 3 years. I'm sure we will continue to hear about your children's great accomplishments in the years to come. Please join me in welcoming Assistant Superintendent Ms. Ambrosini for opening remarks.
Good evening, everyone. I'm honored to be here tonight with you. I just, on behalf of the administration, I would like to take a minute to thank the mayor, the deputy mayor, and the theater board for hosting this special event and for carrying out this fine tradition. The students and families of South Ocean Middle School are so fortunate to commemorate their moving up ceremony in such a lovely venue. And lastly, I would just like to congratulate all of you and wish you much success as you enter the next step in your education and enter the high school. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Ambrosini. It is my pleasure to introduce our first student speaker, Nicholas Cristoforo. Nicholas had the highest cumulative average of a 98.69 for all 3 years at South Ocean Middle School. Please welcome Nicholas for his reflections on South Ocean Middle School.
Thank you, Dr. Pachullo. Welcome to all the families, staff, and thank you for sharing this memorable day with us. Dr. Mays, I'd like you to help me with something. I just want you to hold this envelope for me. You can sit down. Just hold on to that. Perfect, perfect. How did it get so late so soon? It's night before it's afternoon. December is here before it's June. My goodness, how the time has flown. How did it get so late so soon? Thank you, Dr. Seuss. South Ocean has been quite a ride. Together, we have grown and experienced so many different things over the quickest 3 years of my life. Our time at South Ocean can be compared to a deck of cards. A deck has 52 different cards, and there's even a couple of jokers. Each card is different in its own unique way, but as a whole, they form a perfect group, a lot like all of us. In sixth grade, we were all over the place as we were new to the mysterious concept of lockers and rotating schedules. We were all very mixed up. A really good example of this for me is an issue I had with my band locker the first time we were using them. I assumed I could go to my locker in the band room, which is on one side of the first floor, unpack my stuff, and be on time for my next class, which I had 3 minutes for, have to be very far away. Unfortunately, I could not get the locker open, so my 3 minutes vanished. Now I was late and on the opposite side of the school. I sprinted with everything I had all the way to the far side of the third floor. I got there exhausted and nervous about being late, but Mrs. Bear understood, and thankfully didn't make a big deal about it. Thanks, Mrs. Bear. Another memory that I have was that I began to perform magic tricks on a weekly basis, which is where the inspiration for this came into play. In seventh grade, we thought that we were the kings and queens of the school, as we'd been here for a whole year already. Nobody knew the school better than us. It's not like the eighth grader has been here for 2 years. I was very wrong in thinking this way. Just when I thought I had middle school under my belt, as we were watching a presentation in health class, I passed out. Apparently, I wasn't as cool as I thought. I also continued my magic career by performing on a weekly basis to a few of my teachers. Our futures were starting to take shape with the help of our teachers and parents. Dr. Pachullo, as I know you are a teacher and a parent, I'd like you to pick a card. Just touch the back of anyone.
That one?
All right. Take a look at that. I'm pretty sure people in the back can't see it, so say it into the microphone for me.
Ten of clubs.
That card will represent our pathway or our future. Now here we are at the end of eighth grade. We're still together in one piece, for the most part. We have seen a lot together. Together, we've been through the most difficult tests, Mr. Duran, Regents, and finals. Even though we've all had our ups and downs and had different experiences, we all share one thing, our love for South Ocean. We'll miss you, but to quote Winston Churchill, now, this is not the end. It is not even the beginning of the end, but it is perhaps the end of the beginning. Churchill was speaking about World War II. To me, it means that even though our time at South Ocean is over, we're entering a new chapter in our lives. Dr. Mays, I'd like you to open the envelope. Earlier, I quoted Dr. Seuss about time flying. Whether you feel that we are entering sixth grade yesterday or a million years ago, looking forward, we should all appreciate what is happening at the moment, rather than being sad about the past. My classmates, if you're sad about leaving South Ocean, I'd like to remind you of one more thing that Dr. Seuss said. Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened. Thank you.
Thank you, Nicholas. I would like to introduce our second student speaker, Eleanor Hart. Eleanor had the second highest cumulative average of a 98.39 for all 3 years of middle school. Please welcome Eleanor, who will be speaking about looking forward to the future.
Thank you, Nicholas. I think the most interesting thing about a deck of cards are the jokers, because you never know what life's going to throw at you. Taking a few choice examples from our past 3 years, my personal favorite happens to be setting the fire alarm off at play practice. I will never forget that one. But a good thing about the jokers is they always make the best memories and they always get the most laughs. So, in the words of a well-known bear, Winnie the Pooh, how lucky I am to make something that makes saying goodbye so hard. And while in my opinion, anything Pooh says should be treated as scripture doctrine, his words are especially applicable now. How lucky we are. To be going to a school like this one, to have such incredible power and potential in our heads is truly an amazing thing. Not many people can say that. Who knows what you can do with the science, math, dash of romantic comedy, and countless other topics all up here. And saying goodbye is going to be hard, no doubts about that. Leaving something that seems so much like a part of us. But the good thing about a goodbye is that there's always a hello sometime after. Saying goodbye to our school means we will be saying hello to a brand new one in just 3 short months. In fact, I like to think of high school as a sort of trifecta: people, possibilities, and pimples. All joking aside, the future is scary. It really is. You have no idea what's going to happen, what could go wrong. But instead of fearing it and agonizing over every little detail, let us embrace it. Accept the fact that no, life isn't a perfect fairy tale like in the stories. Life has its ups and its downs. But struggling through those things that we sometimes rather not makes us who we really are. You can't do anything with a block of wood until you carve pieces off. You can't be carved into the work of art that you specifically are until we go through some challenges in our lives. The unknown holds so much possibility. Some of the best things that you will ever do, the best things that will happen to you, haven't even happened yet. Isn't that exciting? People could learn about you in 100 years, about how you changed the way people thought and acted. History books could have your name inked on the pages. Or maybe it's not a history book where you are remembered. Maybe it's in the minds of those you've made a difference for. In whatever way you choose, you can change your future anytime you want. You're changing it right now, all of you, and I encourage you to continue doing so. The future is always changing, and the possibilities are endless. Learn to knit, practice the ukulele, express yourself through interpretive dancing, don't suppress that urge. Start running. This next one is more for me than it is for you. Organize your time. Sign up for that club, become vegetarian, pick an elective you've never heard of, write a letter to the governor, talk to a person you've never seen. You can do anything with what lies ahead of you. You are unstoppable. You always have been. So don't let the unknown get in your way, because starting now, you are not only going to change your life, you are going to change everyone around you. You are going to change the world. So how lucky we are to have been here for these 3 years. How lucky we are to have met the people we have, to have made the memories we keep. How lucky we are to have something that makes it so hard to say goodbye. Thank you.
Thank you, Eleanor. At this time, I would like to invite our select choir students back to the stage to perform their eighth grade song. As they walk up, I just want to share with you that each year, Ms. Dell'Italia invites her students to select a song to perform, and they practice that song. And this year, they selected I'll Be There For You by the Rembrandts. Amazing. Thank you, Ms. Dell'Italia and the select choir. Thank you. It is now my sincere pleasure to introduce our wonderful Deputy Mayor of the Village of Patchogue, Mr. Jack Krieger, to make a special presentation.
Thank you very much, and welcome to the Patchogue Theater for the Performing Arts. I'd just like to ask a question. How many people live in the Village of Patchogue? Raise your hand. This is your theater. The residents of the Village of Patchogue own this theater. And the reason why it's here is because about 20 years ago, a group of local citizens came together when they heard that this theater was going to be the target of a wrecking ball, believe it or not. And they got together and they raised the money to buy the theater. And a number of other people in the village, all volunteers, came and cleaned it out and did the renovations and all the work you see here. A lot of this was done by volunteers 20 years ago. And now the theater is run by a small group of people, a theater board of citizens who are volunteers, and the ushers and the people who work at the bar and the ticket takers and all those people are volunteers. And that's what makes Patchogue great. Thank you. Now, a lot of you kids here, a few more years, you're going to graduate from high school, and many of you are going to have itchy feet, and you're going to move on to other places and make your mark somewhere in the world. But many of you are going to stay here, and we're happy that you will stay here and continue with what goes on in Patchogue. Now, I'd like to read this. It's a proclamation awarded by the Incorporated Village of Patchogue. The Village of Patchogue wishes to issue this Mayor's Citizen Award to Nicholas Cristoforo for showing dedication to his school and to his community. Nicholas? Thank you very much, and kids, good luck. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Krieger, and to Mr. Pontieri, who could not be here tonight, for their continued support of our school year in and year out. Thank you very much. An eighth grade awards night was held in early June, and most awards were presented that evening. However, we were unable to recognize some top student awards until just now, since the Regents exams were just administered this past week. I'm very proud of the students who challenged themselves this year by taking high school level courses in both earth science and algebra. I would like to invite Mr. Duran to present the highest earth science Regents exam.
Well, this year's Regents was shrouded in a little bit of secrecy. I must have gotten hundreds of emails saying, what is my grade? And finally, I got it today, about 20 minutes before I stepped into the Patchogue Theater. So I want to hand this out to this year's highest Earth Science Regents exam grade, which was a 99. Congratulations, Wilson Lee.
And now I'd like to invite Mr. Lindquist to the podium to present the highest algebra Regents exam grade.
This is a most unique night with a most unique group of students. I mean, I've been doing this for 32 years, and I have never heard a student tell the person in charge of discipline to sit down before. I've never heard that. It's also a very unique class because in 32 years, I never had classes thank me when I was done teaching them. And I think that is an enormous credit to the parents that are in here right now. Now, this is a unique class. All classes are great, but there's a unique love of learning in this group. There are kids in here who just love to learn. They just come to school with a positive attitude. And as you know, one of the messages of our district is the whole child. And they come in here as whole children. And they love to learn and they love to be in the building. They're just phenomenal students. And specifically in mathematics, the group of mathletes that started as sixth graders competing against seventh graders, and then seventh grade against seventh grade, and eighth grade against eighth grade among all the Patchogue schools in the Belport School District, were undefeated. They won it all each of those 3 years. Now, as far as the math award, for the highest Regents score, it was a stiff competition. There were many, many, many qualified students and some outstanding scores. And in fact, these are by far the highest scores of any Common Core group of kids that I know of. The winner, also with a score of 99, Wilson!
And now we will begin with the presentation of certificates of completion to our eighth graders.
Oh, wait. Nicholas Cristoforo. Eleanor Hart. Giamara Aguilar Brito. Sana Ahmed. Alexander Albrecht. Evan Albrecht. Candace Aragon. Anna Argueta Gomez. Steven Arizaga Tigre. Dylan Acosta. Michael Acosta. Spencer Auer. Aisha Babulal. Sydney Bacon. Yvonne Balbuca Kuji. Victoria Balk. John Barros Chikaiza. Karen Bautista Pineda. Sean Beatty. Jamie Becerra Galarza. Jennifer Becerra Segarra. Tiffany Billups. Diego Bonilla Marga. Ronald Bravo. Brittany Brito. Jordan Brooks. Giselle Bueno. Jocelyn Cajamarca. Melvin Cajamarca. Kenneth Cajamarca Castro. Christopher Cajamarca Sakurai. Stephanie Kando. Alexis Kando Gomez. Jennifer Caraballo Gonzalez. Michael Cardenas. Manuel Cardenas Torres. Jacob Christie. Jonathan Coates. And Jocelyn Correas.
Emma Crowley. Kimberlyn Cruz Reyes. Josh Quadros Bermudez. Hunter Darrow. Molly Dashell. Caroline David. Eliana Delator. Evan Dessing. Michael DiMatteo. Rachel Diaz Ramos. Anthony Dominici. Courtney Donato. Emily Draney. Benjamin Dwyer. Brian Egan.
How do you say your last name?
Yasmin El Tambouli. Hannah Falvey. Jamie Ferreira. Maria Fettini. Sean Flint.
Have a good day.
Catherine Ford. Kimberly Franco. German Fuentes. Veronica Galazara. Jeffrey Garzon. Ava Greco. Carissa Grucci. Sabrina Guarino. Estrella Guevara.
How do you say that?
Guevara Ventura. Guevara Ventura. Bianca Hall. Shayna Harris.
Joseph Harrison.
Jenny Heras Zumi. Juliana Hicks. Alyssa Ingracia. Anna Iniguez. Destiny James. Catherine Huela Cuchimbo.
Evan Coffer. Daniel Kelly. Allison Koch. Jada Ann Krepf. Caitlin Krupa. Kayla Kuhl.
I got it.
Chloe Lesson. Jonathan Leon. Wilson Lee. Curly Livicura Tigre. Catherine Lopez. Natalia Lopez Echeverry. Lizbeth Lucero. Kimberly Lucero. Justine Ludovico. Brandy Ma. Ashley Mancuso. Sydney Mancione. Lena Marin. Aiden McBride.
It's your time.
Robert McDermott. Matthew Michaels. Janelle Minder. Francis Middledorf. Ryan Monteroso Rios. Amber Moreno. Brendan Moses. Michael Nicholas. Nicholas Oaken. Michelle Onse. Alexandria Pappas. Bronwyn Pachukas. Carlos Pelaez Encalada. Jason Panisi.
Sebastian Powell. Lenny Guito Lima. Kristen Rafferty. Sarai Ramirez Vilches. Jared Rayner.
Carlos Reyes. DeAndre Richmond. Gianna Rabataccio. Michael Rodriguez. Archimedes Quimito Rodriguez Maldonado. Camila Rodriguez Rodriguez. Zachary Rosenberger. Kyle Ruland. Evan Rupolo. Paulina Ratowski. Francisco Sanchez Fuentes. Caitlin Sayers. Matthew Schlanger. Spencer Schlitz. Melissa Segara Zakay. Jonathan Segovia Bonilla. Anthony Senecal. Michael Seidy. Noah Smith. Alexander Stacco. Joshua Strange. Lillian Stoom. Jeffrey Tejada Peralta. William Tigre. Joseph Toledo. Emma Unverzat. Sarah E. Ruiz Perez. Alejandro Valen Oliver. Randy Valverde. Davis Valverde Vasquez. Jacqueline Vera. Alex Vera Rocano. Anaí Vera Vera. Tyler Weil. John Werner. Kaylee Wimmer. Brody Wright. Nixon Zuniga.
Let's give all of our students another round of applause. At this time, I would like to make a special presentation. I'd like to invite up Ms. Debbie Bacon. She's surprised, but that's okay. Mrs. Bacon, she has been our PTA co-president this year, and she is leaving our executive board, and I am so appreciative of her efforts in providing so many events for our students throughout this year. So we put a plaque together for her, and it's presented to Debbie Bacon, PTA president, in recognition of your dedication and contributions to South Ocean Middle School 2016-17. Thank you very much. Now I'd like to offer some words of wisdom for our students. Thank you. Thank you. This class of students is very special to me because they entered South Ocean Middle School in sixth grade afraid of lockers and changing classes as I was entering with them as my first year as principal. I've had the privilege to get to watch each of you grow into confident, caring, and capable young men and women. So I grappled with what words I might share with you tonight because of all the rewarding experiences that I have shared with you during these last 3 years. I thought to myself, should I talk about all of the great fundraising efforts that this group has been involved in? Things like the ALS walk, birthday in a box, making sandwiches for the local shelter, St. Baldrick's event, the list goes on and on. Or maybe I should talk with you about some of the amazing experiences that you've had outside of the classroom on field trips, things like going to the Mets game, Fire Island, Adventure Park, the Holocaust Museum, or even your overnight trip to Boston. Well, while reflecting on all of these experiences, I decided to focus on a conversation that I had during the Boston trip. Let me paint the picture for you. It was day one of the trip, and I think my Fitbit registered something like 35,000 steps on that Boston Freedom Trail. And of course, as the nervous principal, I'm out of state on a trip with 90 plus eighth graders. I, along with all the other chaperones, did not get much sleep that first night. And day two of the trip came, and it happened to be the first really hot day of the school year. So I think it was safe to say that all of us chaperones were pretty exhausted while we were at the amusement park. So the chaperones, we gathered for lunch, and we were having some great conversation. And one young teacher, who will remain nameless, began to talk about Snapchat and Instagram. And I looked over at that teacher and said something to the effect of, oh boy, you're such a millennial. And I remember, you know, when my grandparents used to come to me to program their VCR, and now I really have no idea what a streak is on Snapchat. So that comment sparked a great discussion and a great debate while we were at the trip about generational differences. So you seated around that table with the chaperones were baby boomers, Generation Xers like me, and millennials. Regardless of our generational differences and our exhaustion level, we were all there for you so that you could have the best time possible on your eighth grade trip. So you may be thinking, Dr. Pachulla, where are you going with this story? Well, that interaction made me think of this question for all of you. What will define you and your generation? You see, the baby boomers, they were born between the 1940s and 1960s. They grew up in a time of great social change. They experienced things like Beatlemania, Woodstock, Vietnam War, Cold War. They were the first generation to grow up with television. Even more importantly, they influenced the civil rights movement, the environmental movement, women's rights movement. These are some of the things that the boomers will be known for. Generation Xers, which happens to be my generation, were born between the 1960s and the 1980s, early 1980s. Our generation was sometimes referred to early on as the MTV generation, or even the slacker generation when we were your age. However, my generation experienced the first personal computer, the fall of the Berlin Wall, energy conservation, and the beginnings of the internet, which has sparked many new entrepreneurs and businesses like Amazon, and the list goes on and on, Apple. The millennial generation, they were born between the mid-1980s and the early 2000s, and they're still making their mark. However, they are referred to sometimes as digital natives because they are often the first consumers of newest technology. That brings me to you, your generation. Your generation is known as Generation Z. Your generation has been coined by some as the selfie generation because of your widespread usage of the internet and social media. So I Googled selfie, and it's actually in the Merriam-Webster dictionary as a picture that is taken of yourself. So now I ask you, is that really what you want to define you and your generation? A picture taken of yourself? So as you embark on the next chapter in your lives, as you enter into high school, I would like to challenge you to use the prefix of self in a different way than just in the word selfie. Have a strong sense of self-esteem. Feel good about yourself and appreciate your own worth. Approach situations believing that you can be successful, and if you have a positive mindset, you will approach situations with more confidence. Legendary coach Lou Holtz said, "You are not born a winner. You are not born a loser. You are what you make yourself to be." Practice self-expression. Make sure that your personal characteristics and beliefs represent your external actions. Author George Bridgman said, "To express one's inner self so that others can understand you is art. If your expressions are elevated and beautiful, it is good art." Be willing to evaluate your own thinking and actions and behaviors in order to gain valuable insight through self-reflection. Mary Frances Winters, the founder of the Winters Group, a diversity consulting firm, shared some words of wisdom when she said, "Don't become too preoccupied with what is happening around you. Pay more attention to what is going on within you." Finally, I challenge you to practice selflessness by putting the needs of less fortunate at the forefront, being humble and kind to all that you encounter. A famous magazine publisher, Malcolm Forbes, once said, "You can easily judge the character of others by how they treat those who can do nothing for them." So in closing, I circle back to my original question, what will define you and your generation? I hope that your education here at South Ocean has taught you the importance of not just applying yourself and acquiring knowledge, but the importance of being kind, developing your character. I hope that in addition to learning content-specific knowledge, you've gained courage and compassion. These are all the foundations of a well-rounded and positive life. Now that you are the newest students of Patchogue Medford High School, each of you should be confident in your ability to accomplish extraordinary things. However, lasting success comes only from hard work, dedication, and focus. No matter what your middle school years were like, the high school will give you an opportunity to start anew and to define who you are. It's up to you to take full advantage of that opportunity. It is with great pride and enthusiasm that I welcome you as Patchogue Medford High School's class of 2021. Congratulations and best wishes to you all. Our students will now process out of the auditorium and meet their families in the lobby. It'd be most helpful to parents and family members to please wait for all students to exit to the theater before you exit yourself. Thank you all for coming and wish all of you a wonderful summer. Thank you.